Today on Animal Fact Files, we're discussing Andes frogs. It's worth mentioning that these are not the only frogs in the Andes mountain range. This genus just happens to get the common name. As of this recording, there are at least 30 described species of Andes frogs, but more are being described every few years, so that number will likely increase over time. These amphibians live in some of the most remote habitats on Earth. It can take over a day of hiking to reach some of them. Many species from this genus are only known from a single location, such as a certain mountaintop. In fact, some species are listed as endangered the moment they're named. Andes frogs, perhaps unsurprisingly, live in the Andes Mountains. Here they inhabit cloud forests and grasslands that can reach over 2 miles in elevation. These are terrestrial frogs. They spend most of their time hiding under rocks, in moss, in leaf litter, and other places on the ground. Like some toads, they don't even have toe pads for clinging to surfaces. Instead, these vertebrates are small with a plump body and large eyes. Most individuals are not much longer than half an inch in length, though some species can reach triple this. Of course, that's still less than 2 inches long at their largest size. At least for now. Maybe there's a giant Andes frog out there waiting to be discovered. Some species of Andes frogs have relatively smooth skin, but many species also showcase tubercles along their back and on their eyelids. Unlike many aquatic frog species, Andes frogs don't have webbing on their toes. They frequently appear brown along their back with a lighter stomach and red blotches. Something really fascinating about these frogs in particular is that nearly all species lack ears, either internal or external. Although they're frogs, they're not believed to communicate through sound. And, in fact, it's not known how they effectively communicate. Another oddity about Andes frogs is that they don't go through a tadpole stage. Their eggs are laid directly on the ground and hatch into fully formed frogs. Sometimes, a parent will remain with their clutch to keep the eggs protected from potential predators, and perhaps even desiccation. So little is known about these frogs that most sources don't even list their diet. They're restricted to small areas and are often at extreme risk to destruction of these locales. Therefore, habitat destruction is a huge concern for many species. Logging, human-made fires to expand grazing fields for livestock or agriculture, and changes in climate all impact the Andes frog's livelihood. For more facts on Andes frogs, check out the links below. Give a thumbs up if you learned something new today. Thank you to our patrons, SpikeSpiegel93, Dad, and everyone else for their support of this channel. And thank you for watching Animal Fact Files.